And I just want to tell you that that it's just such an honor for me to be here today. All right, let me move forward here. I'm Pamela Geller. I'm going to introduce Pam. Geller spent most of the 80s working at the New York Daily News, first as a financial analyst, then associate publisher and top-ranking business executive of the New York Observer for 5 years. I was a news director in New York City for a couple of years, so I'm very familiar with Pam's work. She co-authored a book, the post-American presidency, the Obama administration's war on, is that Iran or America, with a foreword by U.S. former ambassador to the U.N., a guy I love, John Bolton. Now, the guy's phenomenal. A couple of quickie things about Geller, and then I'm going to get the big hook and get pulled off here. Geller denies accusations of being anti-Muslim, saying that it is a slanderous slur and it's unfair. Ibrahim Hooper, who is a frequent guest, she's nodding, on my show, a spokesman for the Council on American-Islamic Relations, would say that she's the queen of the Muslim bashers. I see her rise and the rise of these anti-Islam hate groups going hand in hand. We need Pamela Geller here as a defender of freedom. She talks a little bit about the... I mean, she's just all over about what we as Americans and American exceptionalism is all about. Let me just introduce to you right now Pam Geller. And it's my honor and my pleasure. And Pam, I will tell you that it is almost as chilling as seeing that spotlight on the American flag last night. You're close.
Happy birthday, America. Really, 236 years. What a fabulous day. This is my favorite day, my most favorite day. Imagine a day that celebrates and exalts freedom. It's an incredible concept. I say this without patriotism or sloganeering or jingoism, that this country is the noblest, the most just, the most magnificent country, the only moral country in the history of man. It is a completely, it deserves applause. Yes, it does. We talk about America and the greatness of America. What is this day celebrating? This day is celebrating the founding principle of this great country. And what makes this the only moral country in the world? The founding principle of this country is individual rights. And I was asked to address American exceptionalism today. And it's such a happy subject. It is the font from which all of my ideas spring. American exceptionalism, is individualism. Is individual exceptionalism. That's why there is no British exceptionalism, contrary to the president, and British and French and Greek. No. The font from which all of my ideas spring is individual rights. I speak for the smallest minority in the world, the individual. Of course, you know that the media is engaged in the art of the smear. This is what they do. I'm not anti-Muslim. I love people. I help Muslims. It's why I do what I do. But I am against the most radical and extreme ideology on the planet that subjugates women, oppresses women, subjugates non-Muslims, denies them basic human rights in countries living under the Sharia. You're damn right I'm going to fight against that. I'm a human rights activist. That's what I do. And it's interesting to be surrounded by so many heroes, unsung heroes. Rich Davis, you know, I know Rich so many years. Rich was an early Atlas Shrugged reader. I remember he would write me, he goes, you know, I see that group across the street. I'm going out there. I'm like, go. And he started this movement, completely organic, completely wonderful. And when I'm asked to speak at tea parties, first of all, let me thank you for having the courage and the chutzpah and the gonads to have me. Because there's a war on the truth. Truth is the new hate speech. And just telling the truth is a radical act. And every time someone invites me, they get into a world of pain. Thank God I'm surrounded by sadists that enjoy it. The extremism smear. Let's dissect it for a moment. Extremism, what is extremism? It's a modicum of measure. Is extremism in pursuit of truth a bad thing? Is extremism in pursuit of love a bad thing? Is extremism, it's the substance of what you're extreme in. But this is the art of the smear. And who knows better than the Tea Party? I mean, the Tea Party was the object of a mass smear campaign. Mass. To destroy the whole party. You had to have the courage of your convictions to say, I'm with tea, after the media got through with you. It's the truth. But I will tell you that you are going to save this country. Oh, yes, you are. Everything great and noble and brilliant that this country achieved was a noble and logical fidelity to the principle of individual rights. I cannot stress this upon you enough. Because let me explain something to you. The essential battle, the war that we are in, is individualism versus collectivism. This is, when boiled down to its essential oils, individualism versus statism. Now, it doesn't matter what hat it's wearing, what cloak the devil is wearing. If it wasn't Stalinism, it was communism. When it wasn't communism, it was the National Socialist Workers' Party, which was Nazism. They say that was right-wing. Read Hitler's writings. It was completely based on socialism. It was a left-wing party. It was collectivism. Yes, I know you're not applauding Hitler. You know, the media will say, oh, look. Subjugating the individual self to the state. And now it's under Islam, yes. There is no individual. There is no unique soul under Islam. I have no problem with Muslims. I want to keep this country free from Muslims that are running to escape the Sharia. But I do not believe tolerance should be applied to evil. Well, I think it was Mann, right? Thomas Mann, who said tolerance when applied to evil is a crime. Yes, indeed. And I will fight that. And I will not be subjugated. And it's so refreshing to be in a room with people who so get it. The gentleman that said, there is no 2016. There is no, it could not have been more sagacious, more acute in judgment. We are living under a regime whose basic premise, and remember, everything comes from your basic premise. So always check your premise when something doesn't fit. Whose basic premise is anti-freedom. He has an anti-freedom agenda in America in subjugating and enslaving the people. It is slavery. And if you want to read a very good article, you'll go over to PJ Media and you'll read my article on Chief Justice Dred Scott decision. If you remember Chief Justice Taney, Rule Taney, well, some it's actually Taney, but I don't want to fight with you. You'll check, and you can send me an apology later. It's perfectly fine. Chief Judge, it's spelled T-A-H, anyway, yeah, okay. Tangential here. Okay. He ruled in favor of slavery, and it was such a fundamentally wrong decision that it literally barreled this country to a civil war, which, of course, was inevitable anyway, because when the Founding Fathers were debating the points of the Constitution, slavery was a big point, and they could not get the South to go along. And if they had not acquiesced to the South, there would have been no United States of America. So once again, it proves the adage that in any compromise between good and evil, evil profits. They left that for another day, and what a bloody and brutal day it was. But Judge Taney ruled that slavery, in favor of slavery, and it set off the country in, as you know, a catastrophic war, which had to be fought, agreed. This, clearly, is a more subtle form of slavery, but it's slavery nonetheless. I will not live for the sake of another man, and I will not ask another man to live for the sake of me. And while we all have our issues, perhaps with Romney, what are we talking about here? It's anybody but Obama. Yeah. Anybody. Anti-freedom. You show me one policy, one domestic policy, one foreign policy of Obama's that was not anti-freedom. One. Show me one. He's enslaving this nation, a $15 trillion deficit, and Obamacare hasn't even kicked in. If you remove our economic power, you remove our power. Internationally, he's ushered in an era of the Islamic supremacists. I mean, people don't understand what's happening because nothing's happened yet in the daily social fabric of your life. But trust me on this. This is 4 years later. The world is a completely different place. Completely. He ignored the only freedom movement in the Middle East, the only freedom movement, which was Iran. June, July, August, because those people have been living under the Sharia. They've been living under the Sharia for 30 years. They've been living under the bloody boot. And you don't have to be a rocket scientist or a Middle East wonk to know. Just look at the crowds. The crowds of people were led by women. Women with lipstick. Oh, haram. Women with heels. Women with eyeliner. They led, and they were meeting bullets with their bare flesh. And he did nothing. Nothing. And yet we know that he invited the Muslim Brotherhood to his speech in Cairo, his submission speech in Cairo in June 2009, when the Muslim Brotherhood had been banned because they are an Islamic supremacist group that seeks to impose the Sharia on every man, woman, and child in the world. And the gentleman that has the care on his show, shame on you. Shame on you for legitimizing a Muslim Brotherhood group that was the unindicted co-conspirator in the largest terrorist funding trial in our nation's history. Yes, yes. And Obama's Justice Department has scuttled the prosecutions of over 300 Muslim Brotherhood groups because the Department of Justice has become the de facto legal arm of Muslim Brotherhood groups in this country. Yes. Anti-freedom. Anti-freedom. So you had him usher in the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt, so they're shelling Israel. I don't care if you like the Jews or you don't like the Jews. It's a shared value system who believes in liberty and justice, and by the way, who is on the front lines of the jihad, just like Ethiopia. These countries are fighting for their lives. They're slaughtering Christians in Indonesia. The Muslims are slaughtering Christians in Indonesia. They're slaughtering Christians in Malaysia. They're slaughtering Buddhists in Thailand. Where are the Christian groups? Forget the media. Forget the media. It's the enemedia. It's the enemedia. It is the largest weapon that the enemy has in their arsenal is the media. And you better know it. And you better know that this is where the war is, and this is why you're so crucial. The war is in the information battle space. The war is in the war of ideas. All the bullets and the bombs and the bloodshed comes as a result of what happens in this war. You. It is incumbent upon you, each and every one of you. When they flew those planes into the towers, were those stockbrokers and mothers and fathers and sisters and daughters and sons, were they wearing uniforms? No. Were they our soldiers? No. Yes. This is the war, and that makes you a soldier. The greatest honor I ever got, and I, you know, I received the Annie Taylor Award for Courage, and I just... I'm not showing off. I just want you to know that I have other things to compare it to. The greatest award I ever got was on the Marines gave me the flag that flew over Helmand Province in Afghanistan on 9/11, on the 10th anniversary of 9/11. It is my most cherished talisman. And accompanying it was the armband of a young Marine who lost his arm. And that was the armband that was on his arm. And so it was, I think their way of saying is, yes, I don't have their courage. they're out there. That's the real deal. Let's not get crazy. But they was, what they were saying was, your war is an important war as well. And each one of you is your own little one-man media organization. You are. You are. You play golf, you play tennis, you play badminton. What do people? I only work, so I don't know what people, normal people do. But the normal people, you have circles. Now, some people are not going to listen to you. You don't need all the people, like that gentleman said. You don't need all the people, and you certainly do not need a majority. You need a critical one-third. Now, the left is basically mentally ill. Forget it. No, come on. Go look at Occupy. They're sleeping in the dirt there. Oh, please, feh. They're so nuts. But the media demonized us. Never a racist word. Here, they're saying a guy, someone called a black congressman, the N-word. Now, there's a million cameras there. You see all the cameras. Nobody has it recorded. But we have recorded on the right the rapes, the seven murders at Occupy, okay? The stealing. I mean, they had a tent for women at Zuccotti Park. Zuccotti Park in New York, where, by the way, my peaceful Ground Zero mosque protest was, the permit was withdrawn. Yeah, the permit was withdrawn from Zuccotti Park. But they could live there and move in there. You think it's not a double standard. They're at war. They know we're at war. And just because we want to be polite, okay, if you don't show up for a match, baby, you lose. You better come full metal jacket, okay? I mean it. Fully armed. You cannot rest. You cannot rest. It is the American response. What is the American response to overbearing authority? I will tell you. Defiance. You must be defiant. She waves her flag in the back. Don't tread on me. You must be defiant. Defiance, not obedience, is the answer to overbearing authority. I know that we're short for time. I mean, there's a lot I'd like to go into. Understand what Lenin said. Lenin said that socialized medicine is the cornerstone of the arch of a socialized state. Once they own that, they own what percent? What is it going to be, 20% of the economy? It's over. It's game over. And I'm not going to paint this as a happy thing. Oh, you know, this was ingenious. He's an evil genius, Chief Roberts. Wasn't he so smart? No, he wasn't. Whether he did not want a repeat, let's say, of Bush, Gore, you know, where the Supreme Court is weighing in on monumental decisions. Hello, just do your job. That law is unconstitutional. If Romney gets in, when Romney gets in, we hold his feet to the fire on repeal Obamacare. But understand, when you're talking to people and they get into the weeds, you know, like the left likes to say, oh, it's so much more nuanced. When you hear nuanced, hold up the cross to Dracula, okay? Deadly. It is individual rights versus collectivism. That's what the fight is. Period. That's why I believe there's a leftist Islamic alliance. People say, the left, what are they doing in bed with the Islamic supremacists? The gays, I mean, call me skeptical, but Queers for Palestine? You know what they do to queers in Palestine? I'm going to tell you what they do to queers in Palestine. They take a razor blade, and they go around the face, and they pull their faces off. That's a true story. Where is now? Where are the feminazis? Honor killings, clitorectomies. I mean, the Swiss just banned clitorectomies and said if you take a kid out of the state, out of the country, and you bring them and you clitorectomize them, we're going to prosecute you here. But do you know here in America, did you know that there is FGM, female genital mutilation, legislation being considered now? And Muslim leaders are calling up the legislators saying this is an attack on Muslim groups. Oh, yeah, you don't think we're far down the rabbit hole? You better wake up and smell the coffee. I'm telling you right now, we're in real trouble. We're in real serious trouble. There's an enemy within and there's an enemy without. And we have lost moderate Muslim countries like Tunisia. They just voted in a Sharia state. Libya, he was a bad cat. I know he was a bad cat, but trust me, a Sharia government is much worse. There are degrees of damage. The loss of Egypt is incalculable. Nothing happens for decades, and decades happen in a day. Where are you going to be when it hits the fan? I'm asking you. Are you going to look your kids in the eye and say, I did everything, everything I possibly could. I knew what was at stake. I saw it. I knew. I knew for the first time in history, the first country based on individual rights was in trouble. And hated by the world, you're damn right we're hated by the world. You want to know why we're hated by the world? I'm going to tell you. It's the hatred of the good for being the good. Bada bing, bada bum. That's it. You cannot sleep. Just as we revered our grandparents and our great-grandparents for saving the world from Nazism, defeating Nazism and collectivism, our children and our grandchildren will hate us for leaving them held hostage to nuclear rogue Islamic regimes. This is here. This is coming. And you have a president who's enabling, sanctioning these Islamic groups, who has given everything to the Russians. Did you see Putin pretending to sleep while Obama was talking to him? They laugh at him. The media is not showing you that. The media is not showing you that. They have contempt for us because we took the most golden gift of all, freedom, and we threw it away with both hands. I urge you, I implore you, there is nothing more important in your life that you do than to save this country. When you wake up in the morning, you rub the sleep from your eyes, you say to yourself, what can I do today to save the Republic? One thing, send an article around. And lastly, I'd like to say about the right, stop abandoning the most effective leaders, okay? You know, I get marginalized. I'm not going to compare myself to Palin, but look what they did to her. She's a perfectly lovely, righteous woman. Perfectly loved, yes. Came up the hard way, earned it the hard way, not part of a dynasty, not part of a political group, not a Bush dynasty, not a Clinton dynasty, nobody. And I'm going to tell you something else. If you think that Romney's going to win easy, you're wrong. Because if Obama, who was a Pisher state senator, could overtake the Clintonista machine, this is no ordinary gang of gangsters. And Romney is really, in my opinion, a little too nice and a little too sweet on the one hand. On the other hand, weak people need a strong man. Strong people don't need a strong man either. But we got to be his spine, and you got to back them up. This is why I think that we have sometimes mealy-mouthed leadership, because every effective speaker is marginalized, demonized, and the right won't touch him. The right doesn't want to touch me. And my platform is human rights. I don't care what the left says about me. They say I said that Malcolm X was Obama's father. I don't know who his father was, so I never said that. And that's the truth. Anyway, I know you're running over schedule. I want to thank you for accommodating me. I want to thank you for coming and being brave and suffering the slings and arrows to be a fighter for freedom. God bless you. God bless America. Happy birthday.
Pamela, we want to thank you for coming and being with us. And besides the gift you're getting right now,
oh my God,
which Don has opened for you.
Oh my God. My own Liberty Bell. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're
such
you're
a
mensch.
Oh, you're
me
so
too.
Good. Me too.
One more thing. Many of the places Pamela goes, she needs security. She had to bring two security people with her here today. And Independence Hall Tea Party raised $700 on behalf of the American Sheepdogs. In the name of Rich Davis and the American Sheepdogs, who we had a conversation with him about this, we want to donate that $700 to Pamela Geller to pay for some of her security expenses. Pamela, thank you so much for all you do on behalf of freedom.